This circuit is a real-time clock and calendar with two alarms. This real-time clock circuit is based on peak 16F877A, which is this one here. It's also based on the DS1307 real-time clock integrated circuit, which is this small chip here. Here we have a 3-volt cell battery, because the DS1307 needs this cell battery. Here we have a 2004 LCD display to display the time, the date and the alarm informations. As we can see, here we have 3 push buttons. This button here sets the date and calendar. This one increments the selected parameter, and the last one is used to set the alarms information. Here we have, this is an LED and this one is a buzzer. This LED is used for alarm 1 and this buzzer is used for alarm 2. The LED here is connected to pin RB3 and the buzzer is connected to pin RC2, which is PWM1 output. The buttons are connected to RB0, RB1 and RB2 respectively from this button here. Now let's set up our time and date and also the alarms. Okay, this the minutes. Let's like this. Okay, we finished setting the time and the date, and the clock is running as we can see. Now let's set up the alarms 1 and 2. Okay, alarm 1, let's turn it on and set up the minutes for the alarm 1. Okay, set up the hour of alarm 1. The same thing for alarm 2. Okay, as we can see, the first row displays the time, the second row displays Monday 5/9/2016, the third row, as we can see, alarm 1 as shown here, 2:13, alarm 2, 2:14. Now let's wait until we reach the alarm 1 time and then wait until for 1 minute until we reach alarm 2 time. Okay, as we can see, the LED is on here. Now let's wait until we reach 2 o'clock and 14 minutes to see what happens for the alarm to. As I said, the LED is associated with alarm 1 and the buzzer is associated with alarm 2. The buzzer needs a PWM frequency or a PWM signal to work. Okay, the buzzer now outputs a sound, as we can hear. To turn off the alarms for alarm 1 or alarm 2, just press this button here. Okay, there is no sound comes from the buzzer and the LED is off.